Basic operating procedure. Every fluoroscopic examination should take some basic things into account. Minimizing beam on time should be a priority. This is basically using intermittent fluoroscopy or brief looks whenever practical, rather than using continuous live fluoro to minimize the exposure to the patient. You can also make use of the cumulative reset timer. An audible alarm should sound every 5 minutes of fluoro, but you should make sure to track the entire amount of fluoroscopic beam on time for any procedure. Optimum technical factors should be employed, generally using lowest MA setting and highest KVP appropriate for the fluoroscopic examination. Many forget to include collimation during fluoro. Limiting the beam size with the shutters visible on the TV monitor along with the selective largest field of view appropriate for the examination will dramatically reduce patient dose. Magnification mode uses more radiation than the largest FOV possible, so limiting its usage to only when absolutely necessary will reduce radiation exposure. As previously discussed, last image hold will prevent re-imaging in many scenarios, which will also reduce dose. Recording the examination, whether you have the ability to utilize newer digital recording equipment or spot film cameras, will allow for later review of the exam without additional radiation as well. And one method for reducing exposure that's often overlooked, especially in the operating room, is keeping the image intensifier as close to the patient as possible. Not only will this improve resolution as the anatomy is closer to the image receptor, the II, but it reduces scatter and requires less dose to produce an optimum remnant beam signal to the input phosphor.